Fundamentals of software testing, epic fails in testing. So what can happen when testing fails? Oh, for us it's somewhat funny to read news and laugh when software is not working and produces strange results and headlines, phones are crashing and these kind of things, trains don't go, supermarkets cannot open when the locking system has failed or something like this. But failing software can have catastrophic consequences. Way too many people have died because of bugs that were not found in testing. So software exists also in hospital environment, in ships, airplanes, as in space, etc., where it's very critical that it works. So here I present 10 cases that have cost a lot of money, lives and brand value, especially brand value. These cases, they are not the 10 most expensive nor deadly, but then various ones to illustrate how we can fail if we are not testing good enough. And of course, with proper testing, all of these mistakes could have been avoided. So people would have not died and millions of dollars would have not lost. First, Toyota Prius software glitch. So Toyota has had these car recalls, also other car manufacturers have of course had these recalls, but in 2014 Toyota recalled over 1.9 million cars. There was a fault in software that could lead the hybrid system to shut down in a highway, and Toyota released this kind of a sentence that the setting of the software could cause higher thermal stress in certain transistors within the booster converter, and these transistors could deform or become damaged as a result. So there is a setting in a software that puts some extra heating to transistor that fails the car. So sounds like crazy, but this happens, and in the end car could enter in a failsafe mode and the hybrid system could shut down and stop the car. Not the thing you wanna encourage when you are in a highway. If you wanna read more, there is a Financial Times article about this. Then the famous Pentium FDIW bug. Intel released those Pentium processors, I think, in 1993, and those very early ones had a bug that made calculation mistakes when large floating point numbers were divided. So the bug was found by a Thomas Nicely, professor of mathematics, and he was doing some mathematical calculation and thought that there is some error, but it took some time for him to understand that the error is not in his code but in actual hardware. And the bug did not affect all calculations but just some that met the required circumstances. So it was something like 1 in a million or 1 in a billion of calculations were resulting wrong results. Intel, of course, in the end offered to replace all the faulty processors. Not all the people wanted even to replace because the bug didn't affect them that much. But for Intel as a brand, it was bad. It was that bad that even I mentioned this bug now, after almost 30 years of after the incident. And there is a Wikipedia page about this bug. Then there is a Medtronic's heart defibrillator and pacemaker, basically artificial heart. The maker of the device had made a wireless way to adjust the device so that you wouldn't have to open person's chest to go and set up new settings there or just something that, and you could just wirelessly do those changes. So eavesdropping the signals from devices could be done, and by that one could collect personal data from one's heart, and also the device itself could be hacked, although only laboratory, and the heart could then shut down or give electric jolts to person carrying that. That sounds way too risky, that I hope that my heart is going to work many years still. And there is, for example, New York Times article about this. Then my favorite one, Ariane 5's maiden flight explosion. So European Space Association was funding this Ariane 5 rocket, and it was totally new compared to Ariane 1, 2, 3, 4 rockets. The 5 is much larger, but still the developing engineers decided that, hey, we can use some code from the Ariane 4 rocket and put that in the Ariane 5. So, and then in the end there was a need to convert 64-bit floating number to 16-bit signed integer. That's okay if the floating point number is small enough, but in this case it wasn't. So there was an overflow in a conversion, and the flight computer thought that the rocket was off course and tried to fix it, and in the end it just went really off course and self-terminate. And the funny part is that this code was not even necessary to fly the rocket. It was a, in a way, fail-safe code, that if the rocket launch would delay it, it would still be okay to launch it. But it was launched in time, and this bad code was running 40 seconds after the launch. After that it was removed automatically, and the explosion happened at T plus 39. So bad luck. And there is a Wikipedia page and nice YouTube video about this. Space science, space engineering is a discipline that provides a lot of these software errors, which are very expensive. Although not people are, lives are lost, but money is wasted a lot. So NASA's Mars Climate Orbiter. When approaching Mars, ground team here on Earth made correction to orbiter's trajectory so that it would not crash into Mars. But ground team had two pieces of software. One was using imperial units, other one metric units. So they have had outsourced a bit of software to Lockheed Martin, and the other part of software was built by NASA. So Lockheed Martin was using imperial units and NASA was using metric ones. So calculations were expected to be in Newton seconds, but they were in pound force seconds. And in the end the orbiter was, it did not probably crash into Mars, but it was just hitting Mars atmosphere and throwing back to space or burning there. No one knows what actually happened. But it was very expensive, of course. And Tim Dodd made a nice video about this incident. And there is a Wikipedia page, of course. Yeah. Then this this Terrac 25 radiation therapy machine, this is one of the saddest cases of software engineering history. So there was old radiation therapy machine, and then they made a new one. And the previous version of the machine used hardware interlocks to prevent errors, so people could not select A and B simultaneously. There were hardware systems restricting these kind of actions, but in this Terrac 25, these restrictions were removed and replaced with software, or at least that was the idea. The software didn't really meet the expectation. It did not work as supposed, and several persons died radiation poisoning. There were plenty of crazy things, just like there was a variable that was set. There was an integer number, and then there is a, if it's zero, no error. If it's one, there is that kind of error. But it was always, it was just increased and increased, so it could even overflow and turn back to zero, and then the machine thought, no, there is no error, when it had multiple errors. This is just so sad. And there is a Wikipedia article about this, good to read, and video discussing the problem. And then Valve Steam client for Linux, so they used this crazy bash code, and there were no checks whether this first step was run successfully, and if not, the second step removed all the user's files on computer. So when you are using RF, it's probably very scary. And there is actually comment in the code, scary, but no checkups to make sure that this Steam root variable has a good content or not. And this is actually not the first time Valve had some issues. I remember back in 1998 when I was installing Half-Life, I made sure that it was installed in a root directory, so that it could not remove the parent directory, which it did if it had not been patched. So this is just crazy. Where is the testing? And there is a slash gear article if you want to read it. And Beautiful Joe 2 memory card corruption. Sony released a demo disc in 1994. It was something like a Christmas gift that included a Beautiful Joe 2 demo. And if a player played the demo, and when he or she had memory cards in his PlayStation 2, all those memory cards became corrupted. So if there was some, let's say, Gran Turismo saved games, those got lost, one could have spent hundreds of hours of collecting and playing games and collecting prizes, etc., etc., and they were lost because of this. The demo disc had a bug in one game, and there is an article about that. No, well, it's not basically an article, but a page describing this problem. Smart Chip USS Yorktown. So United States Army was building this Navy Smart Chip system, and USS Yorktown was installed with this improved computer system in 1996. And then this was just a test bed, and the ship just was utilized to test the program software. And in a next year, a crew member entered zero in the database field, causing an attempted division by zero. and that led ship's propulsion system failed, and it was the ship was sitting dark for almost 3 hours. You just enter zero to database and the whole ship fails to move anymore. Okay, that doesn't sound either any good, and there is a Wikipedia article about this. And then the latest one, Yum cryptocurrency. So in August 2020, new cryptocurrency called Yum was launched, and 2 days after it launched, it was found that bug in code, which is here in the right, rendered the whole currency useless. So there was this division by base or something missed, and the whole currency was useless. And this code was not audited any way. So developers even wrote in a GitHub readme that it is probability, not just possibility, that there are bugs, and there were no bugs, and the whole currency went from hero to zero in less than a day. So better luck next time. There is a the register article about this incident. So nowadays, when computer have started to be our best friends, your car can go to failsafe mode, your artificial heart can be hacked, you can get radiation overdose because of a software bug, all your digital money can get lost because of software bug, and military ships halt because of division by zero. So there is definitely room for professional testing and testers.